Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part 5 of equations and graphs of hyperbolas, and we'll be doing a problem centered at HK. We'll be doing this particular problem on this video. So here's the problem. There's the equation of the hyperbola, and it asks for the center. So let's start with the center of the hyperbola. Well, since we have x plus 1, the x coordinate will be negative 1. Now here I just have a y squared, so it'll just be 0. So the center of the hyperbola is right over here at negative 1, 0. Now that's not part of the hyperbola, it's sort of in the center. So the next thing we want to do is decide whether it goes left and right or up and down in this case. In other words, is it a horizontal or vertical hyperbola? And since the x squared part is positive in this standard form, we know it is going to go left and right. So I'm just going to write a little note here. It's going to go left and right, which means it's a horizontal. So you kind of know it's going to open this way and that way. Okay, that's not a formal thing, that's just sort of like, make a note of that. So let's see. I could think of the denominator here under the x squared part as 2 squared, so I know from that center I go 2 to the right and 2 to the left, and those are my vertices of my hyperbola right there. I didn't ask for the vertices, but you can see what order pairs those are. It's 1, 0, and negative 3, 0. For the y coordinate, from the center, I have to go. Remember, 25 is 5 squared, so I'm going to have to go up and down 5. So I have up here and down here. And that helps me draw the little box, rectangle. And those corners of the box, right, help me draw the asymptotes. All right, so the asymptotes are something that they kind of go right through here. Again, I'm just sketching it. As you can see, my line isn't perfectly straight. I'm just doing, just kind of trying to get closer. All right, so there we go. So to graph this, we use these as guidelines, and we're just opening right and left. It's kind of going to be a big wide hyperbola in this case. Make sure you put the arrows to show it's getting close. Now keep in mind it never crosses the asymptotes, right? That's the idea. So there's our graph. So I'm going to take this off now. All right, what else were we asked for? We were asked for the equations of the asymptotes. Now that's a little bit hard to tell exactly where it goes through the y-axis. So we want to, if we were going to put these in slope-intercept form, it's not super obvious from here. So we could use the formula, which the normal formula for the equations of a line or y equals mx plus b, but instead of just an x, I'll have an x plus 1. That's the only difference. So y, and I still have the y part here, equals, now plus or minus. Now what would the, in fact, I think I asked for the slopes, did I? I didn't ask for the slopes. Okay, but we could write that first. Let's write down the slopes of the asymptotes. It's going to be plus or minus. All right. Underneath the y, I've got a 25. That's 5 squared. It's always y over x, so 5 over, and under the x squared is the 4, which is 2 squared. So it's going to be plus or minus 5 halves. So that's going to be the slope in my two equations. So one will be y equals plus 5 halves, but instead of x, we're writing x plus 1. So if we wanted to put this in slope-intercept form, all I have to do is distribute my 5 halves. So that is one of the asymptotes right here. Okay. And what's the other one going to be? It's going to be negative 5 halves. X plus 1. So if I distribute, I'll get negative 5 halves x minus 5 halves. This is a little bit easier than the one I did on the last video because I just had a y squared. That makes it a lot simpler. So these are the equations of the asymptotes. Now let's see if that looks like approximately. So do I have one of my asymptotes? Does it look like it's going through about 2.5? Well, no, it doesn't, but that's because I didn't graph very accurately. But it, so this is this little asymptote I did should really be going through up a little bit higher. And the other one, is it going through negative 5/2? Yeah, this one looks closer. Negative 5/2. I did a better job of graphing my asymptote that had the negative slope. Okay, but these are the exact equations of the asymptotes. All right, the last thing we're asked to do is to write the equation in general form. So we need to take this original equation and to put it in general form, we're just going to multiply everything out so we don't have any fractions and get everything on one side of the equation. So here's the equation. To get rid of the fractions, you multiply by the least common denominator, which is 100, or 25 times 4. So I'm going to say I'm going to multiply both sides by 25 times 4. So when I multiply the first term times 25 times 4, 4s cancel. And the next term, the 25s cancel. Then I'm on the other side of the equal. I have to remember to multiply 1 times 25 times 4. Well, that's just going to be 100, right? So we've got 25 times x plus 1 squared. So we need to, order of operations, you do the exponents first. So remember, x plus 1 times x plus 1 is x squared plus 2x plus 1. Don't forget the middle term. Oh, and this one's nice. It's just a minus 4y squared. Equals 100. So the only thing left to do is distribute the 25 and then, combine all my like terms and subtract 100. So I'm getting close. 25x squared plus 50x plus 25 minus 4y squared. And I'm going to go ahead and just put minus 100 right now. Minus 100 equals 0. Because in standard form, we usually set it equal to 0. I mean, I'm sorry, in general form, we set it equal to 0. I'm just going to put my like terms together now. So I've got 25x squared. Then I'm looking for my y squared term. Then I'm looking for my x term. There is no y term, and I've got 25 minus 100. So it's minus 75 equals 0. That's the equation of the hyperbola in general form. Now, a lot of times you're just asked to graph the hyperbola. Awesome. All the rest of this is really practicing a lot of algebra, and what we really want to get to is when you're looking at an equation of something that has some x squared and y squared terms, what we're working toward, why we're putting it in general form, is we want to recognize, is this going to be a hyperbola, an ellipse, a circle, a parabola, etc. So that's why it's good to start recognizing what something is by a problem given in general form, because it's not always given in standard form. And the reason we know this is a hyperbola is because we have different signs for our x squared and our y squared term. That's the key. When they're the same signs, it's either a circle or an ellipse, right? A circle means they're exactly the same number, like if they're both 25. An ellipse, maybe one's 25 and one's plus 4. They'll both be positive. Usually you'll write them in the positive form. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.